Respected Chief Guest and Consulate General, Mr. Anurag Bhushan. Respected Guest, Mr. Mangesh Dahiwale, who has arrived from India this morning to specially deliver a speech on this special occasion. Respected senior citizens who are present in this auditorium, and my dear friends, a very good morning to all. First of all, I would like to thank all of you for giving me such a wonderful opportunity to speak in front of so many people. Really, it means a lot. I'm really delighted to say that I always love to speak whenever the topic or subject is about Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, because this subject is actually very close to my heart. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. You know, whenever people talk about Dr. Ambedkar, they always limit him to a leader of the downtrodden people. They always limit him to a leader of the Dalits. Is that he was limited for only this work? Other introductions people have about him. He was the principal architect of the Indian Constitution. Well, that, of course, is the truth. But it would not be confined. And he was more than what people know about him. Even today, after so many years, Dr. Ambedkar is still not fully understood or appreciated by the general masses. What people talk about him as the Masiha of the downtrodden, as the chief architect of the Indian Constitution, is very well the truth. But it would be incomplete to say just that. He was truly a multi-talented personality. He was an intellectual giant. He was an economist by training. He was an anthropologist. He was a sociologist. He was a jurist. And he was the first law minister of India in Nehru's court. These are the various facets of his personality, which people still do not understand. My friends, this is not all. He has done so much more. He has made many contributions in many other areas for the integration of India. With all these dimensions in life, he was a true nationalist at his core. The famous quote, "I am first Indian, and I am Indian in the end, and nothing in between." It belongs to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, and it does not belong to anybody else. Dr. Baba Sahib Ambedkar had before him not only the unprivileged people of the society, but the entire society. Baba Sahib always believed in equality. His vision of social change and reclamation of human personality was universal. During his lifetime, he made many efforts and he used various strategies and methods to create a society which was based on the values of equality, liberty, and fraternity. Dosto, main ek ladki hu, Bharat desh ki putri hu, aur ek ladki hone ke nate, Dr. Baba Sahib Ambedkar ne nari jati par kiye hue sare upkaron se bhali bhati parichit hu, aur unke bare mein kafi kuch padh bhi chuki hu. Swatantra Purv Bharat mein nari ko कोई विशेष अधिकार नहीं थे. Ladies did not have the right to equality. उदाहरण के दौर पर बता दूं, मृत व्यक्ति के संपत्ति का वारिस सिर्फ उसका पुत्र हो सकता था, मगर आज कानूनन वो हक उसकी बेटी का भी है. और ये सिर्फ और सिर्फ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अंबेडकर ने लिखे हुए राज्य घटना के कारण हुआ है. अगर कोई औरत को किसी कारण डिवोर्स दिया जाता है, तो उसकी उपजीविका के लिए उस पुरुष को अपनी आमदनी से उसे शेयर देना होगा. ये भी संभव हो चुका है राज्य घटना के कारण. और हाँ, अगर कोई लड़की विवाह योग्य हो जाती है, she has all the rights to take her own decision, to select her own groom. And these provisions are done into the Indian Constitution by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Ladies were not allowed to take divorce from husband. उसके साथ ही मर मर के जीना पड़ता था. Yes, you heard me right. But today, the Constitution gives all us ladies the right to decide on this. आज अगर पति अन्यायी हो तो कोई भी सज्जन महिला उससे मुक्ति पा सकती है, बिल्कुल कानूनन. दोस्तों, ये बाबा साहब ने हम सबको बहाल किया हुआ भारत है, बिल्कुल मॉडर्न इंडिया. By doing all these provisions into the Indian Constitution, for all the ladies, irrespective of caste and religion, डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर ने सारी महिला जाति पर अनन्य साधारण उपकार किया है. आई एम सो लकी टू बी बॉर्न इन इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया. आई कैन नॉट इमेजिन द लाइफ विच माई फोर मदर्स एंड माई ग्रेट ग्रैंड मदर्स लिव्ड बिफोर इंडिपेंडेंस. थैंक यू बाबा साहेब फॉर ऑल दैट यू डिड फॉर इंडिया एंड फॉर ऑल दैट यू हैव डन फॉर द ह्यूमन लाइफ. माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, celebrating Dr. Ambedkar's birth anniversary is not something for earning merit points. Just like the blind followers celebrate the birth anniversary of their gurus. This is a big mistake if someone thinks it this way. At least, I am not in the favor of this point. And I'm sure many of you here will agree with me. The real purpose of celebrating today, of celebrating this great occasion, to implement and follow his teachings in our life. In my view, we should cherish these memories. We should cherish the memory of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, as he has given all of us here a valid philosophy of life. Dr. Ambedkar was not only a man of intellect, but he was also a man of great moral character. He was a liberal-minded leader with the ideas of democracy, freedom of thoughts and expressions. As regards to the philosophy of life, he was a rationalist, secular-minded and a humanist thinker. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar embraced Buddhism to gain the basic human rights and self-respect needed. He was totally against the inequality of human beings, and the ideology of Hinduism is nothing but the construction of caste system. For the reason, although he was born in the Hindu religion, he decided to quit. He decided to embrace Buddhism, and he did it in 1956. Why Buddhism? From all the religions, why only Buddhism? Buddhism because Buddha's teachings are based on the values of morality and ethics. It has no kind of caste discrimination. It has no kind of caste system in it. Buddha's teachings are modern, rational, and contemporary. And Buddha makes us think and live by a reason. Following Baba Saheb Ambedkar, lakhs of his followers embraced Buddhism, and they are living a life full of self-respect and dignity. Finally, I would like to conclude by saying, cultivation of mind is the ultimate aim of human existence. As the mind cultivates, they seek light of knowledge. As knowledge comes, they understand Baba Saheb. As one understands Baba Saheb, they understand themselves. And as they understand themselves, they are on the right path of liberation. Ye karwa अब रुकने वाला नहीं. बाबा आपका बंदा अब किसी के सामने झुकने वाला नहीं। जय भीम, जय भारत।